Now, your local weather with the KX Storm Team.
49 after the hour. Welcome back.
Well, I like the part when you said it was going to be nice and sunny today, but there's a but there.
Yeah.
Yeah, I wish the temperature was 49. But for some of you, you may see a wind chill of 49 below zero.
Ooh,
in some extreme cases, I know. Unfortunately, that's the bad news. But lots of sunshine. But the good news is this cold snap we're in will be very short-lived. Mm-hmm. So if you can just get through the next 36 hours or so, we'll be back up into the 30s and 40s.
All right.
Good. And it'll be nice. So we'll start out right now taking a look outside to Dickinson. There's a few cars out there still dark. We're about 90 minutes or so away from sunrise. Dickinson is actually one of the quote-unquote warm spots right now, where they've had some extra cloud cover already in Dickinson. You're still a toasty 4 degrees out there with those north winds at 20. It still gives you a wind chill of 17 below zero with that humidity at 64%. It's not that warm elsewhere. You can see in Rolla 15 below zero. These are actual air temperatures, 11 below in Harvey, 6 below in Minot, 1 below in Garrison. I believe Williston and Watford City, you're the quote-unquote warm spots at 5 degrees above zero. With those northerly winds howling out there, wind chills are very, very dangerous out there. 17 below in Bismarck, 35 below in Harvey, 42 below your wind chill in Rolla. Only takes a few minutes of exposed skin for the effects of frostbite to kick in, so cover up if you have to go outside. Because of those wind chills, National Weather Service putting most of the area under a wind chill advisory through noon tomorrow. If you're headed out east, a blizzard warning is in effect through tonight at 6 o'clock, mostly for blowing snow from the snow they got last night. We didn't get a lot of that snow, luckily, this time. As we put precision cast into motion, you can see clear skies will dominate as we go through the day today. Lots of sunshine, but that sunshine will not allow temperatures to warm very much. Unfortunately, it'll be nice and sunny, but you won't get to enjoy the sun because you'll be stuck inside with those temperatures below zero and wind chills 20 to 30, in some cases 40 below zero. But by Wednesday, this cloud cover that you see here is actually ahead of our next weather maker that will usher in much warmer temperatures. Here's the wind chill forecast here. You can see by early tomorrow morning, right after the ball drops, those wind chills 20 to 30 below zero. It gets even worse as we go through the morning hours. Tomorrow, most places approaching 40 below zero before things finally start to moderate as we go later in the day on Tuesday and into the early morning hours on Wednesday. Here's a look at that wind chill graph. You can see 30 to 40 degrees below zero only takes 5 to 10 minutes for frostbite to kick in on your skin. So as I said numerous times, cover up if you have to go out. 2 below is what our high will be today in Bismarck, but those temperatures will be falling as we go through the day to about 10 below by sunset tonight. Not that lucky in Minot. 10 below is the as high as you'll get today with those dangerously cold temperatures. Highs elsewhere today will be stuck right around zero to a couple degrees below zero, except Minot, you'll be the extreme case, 10 below zero. Meanwhile, those temperatures tonight will fall off a cliff, 24 below your air temperature expected in Bismarck, with those wind chill values approaching 35 below zero. To the north in Minot, Williston, 21 below zero with brutally cold wind chills, 35 to 40 degrees below zero. We'll take a look at your extended forecast now. As you can see there, temperatures finally rebounding as we get to midweek, as you're headed back to work or school, which is good news. Temperatures will be back into the 30s and lower 40s. That's one of the things I forgot to say, that the silver lining as we take a look at the extended for Minot and Williston is it is brutally cold, guys, but the schools are off, so we don't have to worry about those little ones standing outside in 40 below wind chills.
Well, Ayla would be just disliking life very much so if she had to go out for recess.
Yeah, I don't picture anybody just
no. I don't think they'd send them out for recess right now.
Exactly.
If they had it, so.
Thanks, Robert.
Yep.
When we come back on Good Day Dakota, we'll have your top stories.
And Aaron Fields will return to explain why a local business is hosting a hands-on gun class just for kids. It's all straight ahead.